Okay. Not as idyllic as I was hoping for with this tractor digger coming up behind me. We're in St. Bride Cemetery, and this is part of Ard's Castle. This is like on the way to Glasgow, only this road further down is obstructed by boulders that are blocking the road. So I was informed by someone on the side of the road in his truck that I can take a detour to a place called Dunoon and then catch the Weston ferry from Dunoon, and that'll take me towards Glasgow. So when I arrived in Ard Castle Park, I saw a sign saying walking, mountain biking, scenic views from the road. And then when I arrived at the car park, I thought, no, I don't want to camp here. So I had a look at the map, and then this was on the map, this cemetery. And in the car park, there was this elderly man who was doing all right for his age. I'm guessing he must have been 80-something. He had three dogs. Two of them were very old. Two of them warmed up to me and let me pet them, but the third was like part terrier and just kept yapping at me. And I'm hoping that this guy is like about to go home, because I don't want to like listen to that or have to listen to that all night. But the ground is really damp, but it'll have to do. And today, let me think, what happened today? I stayed in the castle last night, and then I cycled to Tarbert, and then from Tarbert I went north. I went to the co-op and bought all kinds of reduced badgies and stuff, samosas, which I still have some left. And then I cycled in the rain, and the rain was getting really, really heavy. And I thought, I don't want to do this anymore. So I changed my mind and turned to head towards Glasgow instead of going to Oban or Fort William and doing that peninsula that O'Brien was telling me about. That I just changed my mind, thinking if it's going to be wet, I don't want to do it. And the forecast, apparently it's going to be like raining every day for the next week. Okay, I'm going to make use of whatever daylight we have left. The sun is setting over there, and there's my bike, and I'm just going to set up camp before the light disappears. Okay, that's the sun going down, and I'm happy that my tent's set up. And this is like really the first time I've had to use my tent to keep myself, you know, dry. Well, that's not true. There was that night in the forest on Aran Island, my first night in the forest. But it's a beautiful golden light, and it's like autumn sunshine. So this is St. Bride's Chapel, and I never thought of having a look to see if I could pitch my tent inside of here. It would have kept me a little protected from the wind. Oh, that would have been handy. Yeah, I could have done this. I could have like just camped in here. But down there will do, as long as it doesn't get too windy. Okay, so yesterday wasn't that bad of a day. Like up until about 12:30, I had been outside and it had been raining like a lot and raining pretty hard, and I got lost in the park. That was Ard Castle Park, and it took me a while to find my way out of that. So I wasn't off to a good start, but then for the most part I did ride buses. You know, I took the bus to Glasgow, and then I spent, you know, maybe half an hour in Edinburgh, in Glasgow before I took a bus to Edinburgh, and then I cycled to here. I'm in Newington Church right now, and what I find interesting is here in Edinburgh, you have trees that are like old growth trees, whereas on Aran Island, the trees, they weren't all that old. They were like, a lot of it was like forest, or like planted forest for like the timber industry, or I don't know, maybe they were pulping it to make toilet paper, for all I know. But here you have like old growth trees, which I'm really impressed by. And this morning I woke to the sound of bird song, which I thought was amazing. You know, I forgot about what it's like to awake to bird song. And that's something I didn't experience on Aran Island. On Aran Island, I did see hawks, and I saw pheasants, and I saw little sparrows. But here you have like bird song. You know, there's not as much of it as there was earlier when I awoke. But this is really nice. And the other thing is here, I don't know if it's vandalism or if because the soil is so unstable, but like a good portion of the graves, like they're all knocked over. Which is kind of like too bad, you know, it's kind of a shame. And over there is my tent, which was like really wet when I had to put it up. That wasn't much fun having to climb into a wet tent. Oh look, I think there's mausoleums in here. I'll certainly have to have a look around here before I leave. And then I think I will go to Rosslyn's temple or church or chapel. It's Rosslyn's Chapel. Here's what I mean by all the graves that have been like knocked over. And I really can't tell, like, you know, if this is a result of vandalism or if because the ground is so unstable here that, you know, they've just fallen over. But there's like a lot of them. And no one here to shed a tear upon their lonely graves. This is kind of interesting. There's just a fox who was like on Dalkeith Road, just walking along Dalkeith Road, and there he is now. Hello. I've got some biscuits for you. He's quite old. Look here. So the first time I heard of this place, this is Rosslyn Chapel that I'm approaching. And the first time I heard about this place, John Arnold in high school, he told me about this place. And it makes me think about John and how important he was or is to me. John Arnold was an AV technician at the high school I went to. He was like better than any guidance counselor. And he was someone that we could hang out with and just talk about anything we wanted to. He was certainly one of the most important people in my life, or was, or is. The first time I came here many years ago, there was no visitor center. And I remember someone who worked here said, like, you know, at one time, he said like at one time they used to get like 3,000 visitors a year or something to that effect, and now like after the film The Da Vinci Code they now get like 30,000 visitors a year. But the first time I came here there was no visitor center. There was a big metal canopy over the chapel, and I see that they've removed it. I think they had that up from what I read to protect it, to help dry it out. So it's Sunday and there's a service going on right now, so there's no visitors allowed until like after 12 p.m. It's like £9 to enter, and I'm not fussed about paying £9, so I'm just going to have a walk around. So this is where it's believed like that the Holy Grail, or Jesus's head maybe, from what I read on Wikipedia, is like buried or hidden or kept. And there's supposed to be like a vault at the rear of the church. But none of that's really important to me. Okay, here at Barony Castle, we have what is the largest relief map in the world, which was apparently made by two Polish men, from what I understand. And at Barony Castle, there was like a little gazebo where I had my lunch and was able to dry off my tent. And also do some repairs to my bike. And it's been like a good hour or more, so I should really make tracks and be on my way. Kind of interesting. It's like a corridor of trees, or it's like a corridor, and at the bottom is a altar and ritual sacrifices of some kind. Have had to have taken place here at some time or another. I need to get out of here because I've been here for more than an hour and I need to make tracks. I need to make some progress. After I don't know how many days of rain, the sun is shining. funny, after the last couple of days, I thought for sure, like, the sun wouldn't come back. Well, that's not true. I knew it would come back, but I'm just so glad that the sun's shining again. Earlier, I was cycling on this road from Peebles going east, and it was highly unpleasant. It was busy, and there was one boy racer that was being really aggressive. But now I'm cycling along a bicycle path that follows the Tweed River, and I can't believe how beautiful it is. Experiencing a mix of euphoria and sadness. Okay, so I'm now in the back of I'm terrible. Did you say your name's Brian?
Brian.
Okay, yes. I'm now in the back of Brian's car. I'm with Brian and his daughter Erin in the back of their van, and I've got my bike, and Brian has his bike in the back here too, and Erin's is up on the roof. I met Brian and Erin while cycling along the Tweed River. And what's the name of that town that's famous for mountain biking?
Innerleithen? Yes.
And I couldn't get over how beautiful the scenery was with the sun shining. I was experiencing a mix of euphoria and sadness because I thought it was so beautiful and I wanted to not just cycle through this place but get to know it. And now we're on our way to Galashiels, is it?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
We're on our way to Galashiels, and Brian is going to help me sort out my brakes, which I'm really grateful for. And I'm going to just sign off for now. Okay, so it's Monday, the 15th of October, and I survived camping here. And I like, you know, the trees and the chirping birds. I'm not too fussed about bags of rubbish and the TV set or the television. I'm in some sort of like service yard. There's like yellow piping, and there's so far two vehicles have like driven in here. One to open the gate, the other to drop something off, and I managed to stay here undetected, but I'm on my way out now. And, you know, even though this place, it's not nice with, like, the rubbish, it's still nice because, you know, I'm surrounded by trees and chirping birds, and this morning I almost tripped over, like, I think these might be warrens for foxes or badgers or chupacabras, but there's like 1, 2, 3, and even though it's not the most idyllic, it's still not too bad. It was safe, it was like, you know, quiet. There was a train passing by. I'm right beside the Tweed River. I'm only 2 miles west of Melrose, and from what I understand, Kelso is only Morpeth is only about 50 miles away, or 50 or 60 miles away, I believe, which means I should get there today. So it's just inside here where I camped, and I don't know what this place is, but it served me okay. And now it's like three miles to Melrose, or not even. And then off to maybe Kelso. And these gates were locked last night, but there was like these fences you could walk around or walk past to get in here. Not fun with like transport trucks whizzing past you, but it hasn't been too bad. Sun shining at least. Okay, trio. So I'm up on the border right now, Scotland and England. I think these are called the Pennines. And I was really appalled by the amount of litter here when this gentleman, there he is there, and with his dog, decided he'd start picking up some litter, and then I gave him a bag because I have all these bags for keeping my stuff dry, and then I ended up giving him a hand collecting it, and he's taking it with him in his car because there are no bins up here. But we have this beautiful surrounding, this beautiful sunny day, and then when you arrive here you just see all this litter, and like, it was kind of, I don't know, appalling. But it was really nice of this gentleman, who's very middle upper class, to you know, start collecting it. And then I gave him a bag, and then we both began collecting it. And now it doesn't look so bad. Okay, for years I've been, you know, doing this collection of photos called, you know, Side of the Road. It's pictures that I've taken from the side of the road. Here's something that I don't like to see on the side of the road. And I'm reminded of a film I saw about this motorcyclist in Australia. And I find this very sad. So that's the road I was cycling on when I saw this like barrier and thought, okay, here's an entrance to get into the forest. But I wasn't sure if it was like Ministry of Defense grounds, because I'd seen a lot of that on my way here. And then I followed this path, and it took me to this like little clearing here, and that's where I camped. And it was really, really quiet, except for earlier this morning you could hear like the what sounds like the tortured cries of cattle, and I had been wondering if, like, you know, their calves had been taken away from them or something like that, because that's something I experienced in the past, where when calves were taken away from dairy cows, the mother's anguished cries could be heard for like days after. These paths may have been nice to cycle through at night, but I couldn't find my headlamp. But there was enough moonlight, the sky was relatively clear, and I thought I could camp without my tent, but I'm glad I did set up my tent, because you can see how wet it is. So I don't know if this is just morning dew, or if it did rain during the night and I slept through it. It's quite possible it did rain, because it is very wet. Before I sign off, I'm only about 15 miles away from Morpeth, which was my destination for yesterday, which I could not reach. And I was pretty exhausted, like I was yawning as I was setting up my tent and putting stuff together. Okay, so here's the road I was cycling on last night, and as the sun was going down, you had these amazing like purple, violet, pink hues in the sky. I don't know, maybe there's some red. I'm making this up as I go along, and it was really nice. But then I saw this and I thought, hey, I should maybe call it a night and turn in here. So I that's my bike. Isn't that like kind of insane, all the stuff I'm carrying? But that's going to be reduced to about half. And because a lot of it's wet, it's not packed down properly. I passed by a lot of these Ministry of Defense MOD sites, and then I saw this like CCTV in operation. And then I saw like, you know, well, the barricade, keep gate locked. And I thought, okay, it doesn't look too inviting. But then you see at the end here, dogs on leads, please. So even though it's a little intimidating and uninviting, it's like, you know, there's this invitation to, yeah, come on through, but keep your dog on a lead. And what I find amusing is like the CCTV in operation, like it's a forest. Do they have cameras up in the trees, or is it like satellite? Who knows? So when I was like going, when I woke up in the middle of the night to go for a wee wee, I was like wondering, is there any CCTV on me? But I wasn't too worried about it, but it was just a thought I had. Well, now that I'm packed, like that's an insane packing job, or my bike is packed and I'm ready to go, I'm gonna go. Signing off. So yesterday I saw this deer that I, on the side of the road, and I had to move it further into the forest, and I thought like, how sad. But like, look, you have all these sheep, like look at them all. And all they wanna do is just eat grass and reproduce. They're harmless. And all of them are doomed for the slaughter, and like that's really sad too. And so what? Like, you know, a deer, one deer I saw on the side of the road, but I'm thinking like, yeah, it's very sad, and I was really upset to see that. But like, this is upsetting too. Like all these beautiful sheep, they just want to, like, you know, eat grass and reproduce, like, and we're going to, like, chop off their heads and eat their eyeballs. Well, not we, but, like, you know, in other countries where they do that. And this here's the forest I camped in. And what's funny is further back there, I saw a sign on one of those barricades that said, no camping. Okay, this is probably one of the most interesting cemeteries I've ever seen or been to. It's just like a cemetery that I kind of like. It's got all these really interesting grave markers or gravestones. And there's this really old church. It's almost like, I don't know how to describe it. But what else is interesting is you have all these graves with skulls on them. There's one. And then here's another. And then there's another with another right behind it. If I last night I camped in the forest, but if I had cycled for like another 30 or 40 minutes, probably 40 minutes, I would have arrived here, and this would have been a nice place to camp. I could have pitched my tent down there. '56, '03, '1854, just to give you an idea. This is the place me and Augie walk to, like, in the evenings sometime. He'll, like, wear his pajamas and we'll come out here, like, at night for a walk. I think it's one of my most favorite places in the world. I'm in Morpeth. I've made it. Oh, flip. There's, like, stairs.